Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the class. In today's class, we'll discuss 2017 previous year question for the topic called assignment problem, which came for 10 marks in the exam. And this problem is about unbalanced assignment problem. So guys, it is very important that when we are trying to solve the problem by Hungarian approach, we need to make sure that the matrix should be square matrix. If you see in this problem, you have five machines. But if you see the job, we have only four jobs. Okay, so automatically that means it is a rectangular matrix. It is not a square matrix. And actually, when we solve the problem by using Hungarian approach in the assignment problems, we need a square matrix. So here you can see you have five machines and you have four jobs. Okay, and you need to work on an optimal allocation. You need to work on an optimal assignment of jobs to the machine that will minimize the total setup cost. Okay, so how we can do this? So that is what we are trying to learn here to solve this given problem. Fine. So in order to work on the setup, when we are doing the setup, so first of all, we know that the objective function is minimization. Okay, first of all, we know that because time is given. So time, just when we look into the time here, so the time you will try to minimize it, right? So this is setup time is given. You never do any work where your objective would be to maximize the timing of the work. You always work, if the factors like time is given, you always try to make sure that the time for doing the work should be minimized. Okay, so I hope you are understanding the fact. And so here the objective function minimization, but when we see the matrix, it is a rectangular matrix. So what we will do, we'll convert this rectangular matrix into square matrix. So what we'll do here, so here when you see this problem, because the rectangular matrix, it have five column but four rows. So I'll convert this rectangular matrix into square matrix. So I'll write this as 10, 11, 4, 2, 8, okay. So 7, 11, 10, 14, 12, then 5, then 6, then 9, then 12, then 14, then 13, then 15, then 11, 10, then 7. So then 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Done, everyone. So now it becomes a square matrix. No? Now it becomes a square matrix, correct? Now, once you see it is a square matrix, so what we'll do, we are going to solve this problem by Hungarian approach, right? So what you will do in the square matrix, find the minimum element in the row. The same approach which I am doing from last so many classes. Whenever we have a Hungarian approach, find the minimum element in the row. Subtract all the elements of the row from this minimal element. So this would be 8, 9, then 2, then 0, then 6. Then this will be 0, then 4, then 3, then 7, then 5, then 0, 1, 4, then 7, then 9, then 6, then 8, then 4, then 3, then 0, then 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So I did row wise. Okay, I found out the minimum element, subtracted all the element of the row from this minimal element. Now I'll talk about column wise. So column 1, this is 0, column 2, 0. So you see everywhere, column wise, you have 1, 1, 0, right? So there will not be any change. Okay, so subtracting the zero from all other elements doesn't make any sense. So what you can do now is you can start doing allocation. So the first row, one zero. So you can do allocation here. You can cancel the zero. Then second row 1 0. You can do allocation here. Okay, and you can cancel the corresponding zeros in that row and column. Third row nothing can be done. Fourth row 1 0. You can do allocation here. Then second column 1 0. You can do allocation here. Cancel, done. Now guys, if you see, the first row is allocated, second row allocated, fourth row allocated, fifth row allocated, but third row is not allocated. So any row which is not allocated, tick that row. So any row which is not allocated, what you will do, tick that row which is not allocated. Okay, tick that row which is not allocated. In that row, go and tick the corresponding column where zeros is there. Go and tick in the corresponding column where zero is there. Yeah, I tick it. Yeah, I did that. So go in that row which is not allocated. See where zero is there. Tick the corresponding column for that. Yeah, I have done that. Now see in that column where is the allocation. See in that column where is the allocation. Tick that corresponding row for that. Done, right? Yeah, I have done that. Now what you do? Now what you have to do? Draw a line over ticked column and unticked row. Fine. So once this is done, now what you do, see the elements which are not at all allocated. See the elements which are not at all allocated, where not at all allocated means over whom no line passed on. You can see I have highlighted them. Out of these elements, find the element which is having minimum value, that we call a theta. Theta here is equal to 1. Okay, everyone. Now what you will do, guys, this is what 5x5 matrix, right? So whatever is your theta, subtract theta from all the elements which are not allocated, like 4 minus 1. So you can say 3. So this is 3. Then 3 minus 1, this is 2. Then 7 minus 1, 6. 5 minus 1, 4. Okay, then 1 minus 1, 0. 4 minus 1, 3. 7 minus 1, 6. 9 minus 1, 8. Okay, then all the elements over which one line only passed. Over all the elements over which only one line passed. Which are those elements? This, you can see now only one line passed over them. All the elements over which only one line is passed. You can see I'm putting green color highlighter on them. All the elements over which only one line is passed. Okay, simply write them. Okay, don't change their value. Whatever is written, you simply write them. So it was 9, 2, 0, 6. Okay, then 8, 4, 3, 0, then 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, and now all the element over which you can see two lines. All the element over which you can see two lines. Can you see this highlighter, the blue color highlighter? I put all the lines over which you can see two lines, like a cross. So add theta on them. Add theta on them. So 8 plus 1, 9. Then 8 plus 1, it was 9. So this would be 0 only. This would be 0 only. This would be 0 only. No change. 6 plus 1, 7. And then again, over 0, you have two lines passed. So 0 plus 1, 1. Done. 5 into 5 matrix. Yeah. So now what you do, now again you try to do allocation. So this is allocated, this is cancelled. Now this is allocated, now this is allocated, this is cancelled. Now this is allocated, this is cancelled. Okay, then second row nothing, third column this is allocated, this is nothing. Now you can see all the allocation done. Done means we are done. We got the answer, and we will get the 10 marks for that. I hope you understand. It was easy problem. Now this is your final answer. Just put these values, the allocation, the values of allocation, what you get, put this value in the original matrix. Okay. Put this value into the original matrix. So remember the original matrix, whichever, just write down the original matrix. So your original matrix is 10 11 4 2 8. Okay, then 7 11 10 7 11 10 14 12 14 12, then 5 6 9 5 6 9 12 14 12 14 5 6 9 12 14 13 15 11 13 15 11 10 7 10 7. Okay, so see the allocation. First one is fourth, second one first, third one second, fourth one last. Can you see that? Yeah. If you see, this is the allocation. Fifth row I'm not doing, because fifth row though it was dummy, right? I simply insert. So I just find the total cost. So the total cost equal to ₹9 9 plus 13 9 plus 13 rupees 22. Understood, everyone? Then anyone have any doubt? You got it right. It's very easy. You'll get 10 marks for this. Any doubt, anyone? So we'll do this much, guys, for today class. We'll continue our discussion tomorrow. Thank you, everyone. Anyone, any doubt, any question?